Hello and welcome back to my channel. I am Dr. Shaheen Khanam and today I am going to discuss about torticollis. But before that, if you are new here, please consider subscribing to be updated with such medical videos. Torticollis is basically a condition where a child's head is twisted and it's tilted to one side. This is because of shortening of a muscle which is called sternocleidomastoid, and this condition is also called wry neck or logsia. And it's basically of two types. It is either congenital or acquired. Congenital is when a child is born with this condition, or acquired when a person acquires it through their lifetime. So basically this term is derived from a Latin word tortus, which means twisted, and collis, which means collar. So the collar or the neck is twisted. So there are several presentations, including flexion extension, right or left tilt, and right and left rotations. And based on that, they have terms like horizontal torticollis, when there is a right or left tilt, or vertical when there is a flexion extension change, or oblique or torsion when there is a rotation. Before moving ahead, let's just see a little bit of anatomy involved. So the primary muscles involved in this condition has cervical dystonia, which means that dystonia means when there is an involuntary contraction of muscles present. So the muscle that has dystonia would be our SCM, which is the most targeted muscle. SCM is sternocleidomastoid, which has two origins, one at the clavicle end and one at the sternum, and it inserts into the mastoid process behind the ear, and based on its origin, it performs contralateral rotation. Means the SCM at the left side of my neck will let me perform right side rotation, and this left side SCM will let me perform left side flexion and left side tilting. Okay, the other muscles involved are splenius, trapezius, scalenes, and platysma. And based on every cervical level, there are 8 cervical nerves, and if these muscles are affected, it could be in severe cases affecting the nerve, and that could be deadly. What we have to understand here is that torticollis is a symptom, it's not a disease. Okay, there are certain diseases which lead to this particular symptom, and that diseases can be simple, like when there is only contraction in the SCM muscle, to life-threatening conditions where there is a tumor which is causing this torticollis. And like already said, that this can be congenital or acquired, and it's more common in children like who are born with congenital condition, and it's affecting 75% of patients on the right side only. So the etiology here in newborn would be during labor or delivery, or infant position in the uterus itself, or any birth defects. And for older children, like in acquired cases, it could be injury to the muscle, like any trauma or infection or various other causes, which we'll discuss later. So the clinical feature is that there is twisting in the neck, and the head is tipped to one side and the chin is facing the other side. Spasm could be present, and other symptoms depending upon the primary disease could be there. Like for example, if there is a tender lymph node, it could be because of infection. So that infection is the other symptom. This image shows a person with normal neck and somebody with torticollis. You can see on the lower image that on the left side, there is the SCM is bent to the left side. Now discussing in detail the types, congenital and acquired. So first, congenital type, it is also called CMT, or congenital muscular torticollis. CMT is that where there is muscular disorder causing this shortening at birth or shortly after birth. It's more common in females, and 75% on the right side, and the muscle affected would have fibrotic changes with or without presence of mass. So within the first 4 weeks of birth, parents notice this condition and it's presented, and the reasons for CMT would be like overcrowding environment, like in multiple pregnancies, more like in twin babies or triplets, or firstborns, because during first baby usually the labor and delivery is difficult. Then Then is oligohydramnios, when the amniotic fluid is less and so the baby or the fetus is not able to move around properly. Then breech presentation or difficult delivery due to any condition. So this can be diagnosed with ultrasound only. The SCM is quite enlarged in structure and also normally it's hypoechoic and homogeneous. But in this case, there will be a change in the echogenicity, as we can see in these two pictures. In this particular image, we can see there is short echogenic lines. Echogenic lines means that the waves returning back in the ultrasound is normal or short, but when the size of the muscle increases, these waves would be higher. And as is, we can see here in this particular picture, when the SCM size is seen to be greater than the previous one. Management for congenital muscular torticollis is usually conservative, where the tightened side is stretched or given stretching exercises, and the other side is usually weak, so given strengthening exercises and to maintain balance and symmetry. And collar can be given even after this. 5-10% don't respond to conservative management and require surgical release. Coming on to next, which is acquired torticollis, which a person develops during lifetime. So it is of 5 types basically. It could be self-limiting because of some trauma, because of some infection, some inflammatory condition, or CNS tumor or lesions. Self-limiting means a painful neck muscle condition or a stiff neck, which occurs to like every person once in their lifetime according to researchers, and it is spontaneously recovers within 1-4 weeks, and it is usually told to be because of unusual posture, sleeping habits, or because of some cold wind, and or maybe some other cause which is not the etiology is not known. And this is usually related to the trapezius and SCM involvement. Next is trauma. So any injury to the structures around the neck could lead to torticollis. So there are some conditions discussed here. First is occipital condyle fracture and facet dislocation. As we can see in this picture, that the how the occiput is fractured at one side, and that side there will be an inclination or bent, and then the facet gets dislocated, as we can see in the picture. Then next condition is atlanto-axial rotatory fixation, or it is also called ARF of C2. So we can see in the first picture that how the occiput and C1 C2 are not in line because of the rotation. And then the second picture shows a manipulation which is done and they are brought back together. And the third one also shows a deformity of C2 and showing the black arrow where this facet deformity at C2. And the first one is the occiput and C1 rotational deformity. So all this will lead to twisting of neck to one side until mobilized. So it will lead to torticollis. Next is spontaneous spinal epidural hematoma. So at the spinal level, the epidura is the covering of the spine. There would be hematoma, which means that there is bleeding or accumulation of blood. So this is a rare disorder which might manifest painful torticollis because of weakness and sensory loss. And why this will happen? It will happen because wherever there is accumulation of blood, there would be certain structures anatomically present there which are compressed, and those structures, the function would be lost, and there will be sensory and weakness present. Next is subarachnoid hemorrhage. So subarachnoid is the space between the brain and the covering of that brain. So this space, there could be bleeding, which can be because of head trauma or head injury, and it can also be because of non-traumatic, like when there is aneurysm or there is any the arteries have any malformation, and hence there would be bleed. Now needless to say, the investigations required, as we have only seen CT and MRI, so CT and MRI would diagnose any traumatic reason for torticollis. Next condition is infection and inflammation. So the infections from the head, neck, or the spinal column could lead to irritation in the ligamentous area, and there would be a torticollis. So these conditions could be like CNS related, like meningitis, when the meninges, which is a covering of the brain, is inflamed, or there is upper respiratory infection, or otitis media, which means there is painful middle ear, which could lead to bending of the neck to one side. mastoiditis or Bezold's abscess, which means abscess around the SCM muscle which inserts at the mastoid, then cervical adenitis where there is lymph node inflammation at the neck, then retropharyngeal abscess, abscess present behind the pharynx, then spine related could be osteomyelitis, infection of the bone, or epidural abscess, the epidural of the spine is having an abscess, or rheumatoid arthritis which has some deformities and that could lead to a wry neck. So for investigation, lung changes or changes in rheumatoid arthritis can be seen in x-ray only, but ultrasound gives a good impression of lymphadenitis or abscess. CT is required for pre-surgical planning, for looking for the spaces, and MRI, like here we can see epidural extension, can be good for having increased sensitivity. The next cause for acquired torticollis could be presence of tumor, which can be at the brain, spine, or the neck, and this would cause the irritation of the dura mater. And if the any other cause of acquired onset of torticollis is not proven, then MRI should be done for the for looking for tumor. The other causes could be intake of drugs like antipsychotic, antiemetics, and neuroleptic class, which causes dystonia, that is involuntary contraction of the muscle, so it would lead to torticollis. Conservative management would be physiotherapy management, where there is gentle range of motion exercises done, and also stretching, as we can see in the first picture. Stretching can be done in supine posture, or also positional stretching can be given. Like for instance, this child has torticollis on the left side, and the hand is placed just under the right side, and gradually it is let loose, so that with gravity stretching can be done without being painful. That was for CMT, but for older children who have acquired torticollis because of any secondary cause like inflammation or infection, then antibiotic and rest and medications to be given, along with there is passive range of motion to be done, and if required, surgery is indicated. If the cause is due to trauma, then muscle relaxants, and then again passive motion and collars to be given. Collars vary according to the severity of the condition, and it could be customized, like the first child is wearing, and positional traction can be given. Stretching in sideline is beneficial, as gravity also works and it can be maintained for longer duration. In 10% of the cases, conservative approach do not work and they require surgery, but surgery can be scheduled only when they start going to at least preschool. And in the surgery, and the SCM is lengthened just above the 1 centimeter above its origin. Incision is made, which is 3 to 4 centimeters transverse, and it is done endoscopically with minimal approach, and it's such that the patient can go back home the same day. Just to conclude that torticollis is a clinical sign which signifies an underlying disorder. So in CMT, the disorder could be anything related to prenatal life in the womb, and it can be diagnosed by ultrasound. And if for older children, because of any accident or any trauma or infection, a CT and MRI can well diagnose, and the management of the underlying cause can go hand in hand along with the management of the signs of torticollis, which would be lengthening, which would be like first is conservative management by giving stretching exercises, and then if not, then giving the surgical approach of lengthening the SCM muscle. So if you like this video, give a big thumbs up, and if you are new here, do subscribe and hit the bell icon so that whenever I upload a new video, you get notified. And also thank you for staying till the end. If you have any doubt, do comment below and I'll be happy to help you. Thank you. Have a nice day and all the best for your exams.